I'm gonna be driving my car on a go-kart track. It's gonna be sick.
It looks like I can drive this and do most of it sideways. I'm freaking pumped. All right, I'm gonna do my first drift. The corner's looking sick. I got a couple camera angles. It's gonna be an unreal day.
Mm-hmm.
Thinking it's my ring gear from dropping the clutch to initiate the drift. I went in, initiated with the clutch, and it just snapped the ring gear tooth. I think a couple teeth are gone for sure, but I'll have to see. If it's an axle, I'll be right back out there in no time, but I think this is the end of the day. Yeah, that transmission did break, but it literally does not owe me anything. I'm not upset at all because I was only like half an hour drive maximum. Didn't get charged. I'm very happy, dude. Great people at Erbsville Cartway, that's for sure. I'm pretty pumped on the whole setup of the track. It's definitely big enough to drift. I was drifting. I was taking it easy, getting into it, and then she broke, unfortunately. But that's the way she goes. That transmission I've had before it was even twin engine in the rear. So I've just literally swapped engines. It was on every engine that was in the back. And yeah, same with that welded diff. That welded diff has seen some stuff, let's just say that. So I'm pretty stoked on how long that tranny's lasted, but I'll have to either fix it and bring it back or rip out the car apart and then start with my new engines that I want to install over the winter. Do you remember that the last video I said my tranny's acting funky, that in reverse it felt really weird, and that was clearly an issue. So now the entire drive line is locked up. Getting it on and off the trailer was, it just broke free. But like, yeah, it'll lock up then unlock. Yeah, this thing is mucked and I'm still smiling. You can't let it get you down. I honestly don't think that tranny owes me a thing. It's seen Hoonigan, it's seen third gear burnouts, it's seen drifting, it's seen probably over 100 drag racing passes. Because I had this tranny in the back engine, whatever engine I had in there at the time, and it was drag racing when I just had rear engine, and then I had that welded diff in there. The welded diff's held up for 2 or 3 years, I've had it in 2 different trannies. So this tranny alone has been in this car for 3 years. It's been, some parts have been changed and stuff, but for the most part, it's been mint. It's seen my third gear burnout. Yes, anyways, you get the point. It's seen a lot. It's seen a lot. So I talked to the owner and he thankfully said that I could come back and try again. So I'm thinking I'm gonna just put a tranny in it. So I've gotta pull the engine and tranny out and I will have a welded diff and everything assembled in a new transmission. And all I'll do is pull it out, put a new tranny on, drop it in. And I'll probably do that within a day of the swap. And then I'll fire around with the transmission before getting one ready, all set up. But honestly, it's not a huge job to do a tranny. It really isn't. So I think I might just do that and get back out there, get some more fun times on this car. I've got a lot of fuel. That's one thing. I've got a full thing of E85. I'd like to definitely burn some off because it might not be good in the spring, so we'll see. All right, we'll see you in the next one. Like, comment, and subscribe. Because I will definitely be going back to Erbsville Cartway to drift this thing. And this is definitely the first car that's ever been drifted there. So that is so sweet. I'm so thankful. So we'll see you in the next one.